Hello students and welcome in the online session of class 9th science. New chapter is being started today, that is chapter number 11, work and energy. This is the first video. So let us see the learning objectives. Today we will learn about work, work done by a constant force, unit of work, energy and unit of energy. So let's start with the first slide about work. Now in general terms, when we talk about anything which we do, we call it as the work is done. Suppose you are carrying a box, then you say your work is done. If you have supposed read a book, a work is done. If you are holding a weight without moving from your place, then also you may say that you have done some sort of work. Now, if you are trying hard to move a rock, then also you will say that some work is done. Because after doing any of these works, we get tired. The work can be mental work or physical work. So in general terms, work means whenever we do something, we call it as we have done some work. But remember children, the term work is different in science and in our daily life. In our daily life, everything whatever we do, we call it as the work is done. But according to the scientific definition, there is no work done in all these above examples. Okay, right when we are reading a book, we have not done any work. If we are holding a weight and if we are not moving, means no work is done. If we are trying hard to move a rock, but the rock doesn't move, that means no work is done. So let's see what is the definition according to science then. So in science, work is done when a force is applied on the object and the object is displaced from its original position. Fine. So this is called work in terms of science. Whenever you apply some force on the object and if the object get displaced from its original position, then and then only it is said that work is done. Otherwise, no. If no force is applied, no work is done. If there is no displacement of the object from its position, then also no work is done according to the science. Fine. So here also in this picture also you can see the definition of the work. Okay. So you do work anytime you exert a force on an object that causes the object to move to some distance. That means work is done. As you can see in the picture also, the boy is carrying this cart. Okay. So what is happening? This boy is applying force here and due to which this box is moving in this direction. That means the boy is doing some sort of work. But if the object does not move, suppose this cart does not move, that means that no work is done. Okay, so there are two conditions which you have to remember related to work. First one, that force has to be applied on the object. And secondly, the object must move from its place. Then and then only work is said to be done. Otherwise, no work is done. Now, let's move on to the next slide and see work done by a constant force. Now, the direction of the displacement of the object and the direction of the force can have different relations. Okay, now two conditions we have seen related to work, that a force has to be applied and displacement has to be done. So, what is the direction of displacement and what is the direction of force? So, they have different relations because direction can be different. So they have different relations. So directions of force and the displacement may be. See, so both of these we have to check now. So what can be the conditions? So the direction of the force and the direction of the displacement can be same. This is the first case. The direction of the force and the direction of the displacement can be opposite. This is another case. Third one, that two of them are perpendicular to each other. And fourth one, there may not be a displacement at all. This may be the condition that there is no displacement at all, only force is applied but no displacement. So these are the four different conditions which we have to now study about, right? So the first one you can see here, that force is applied in the upward direction but displacement is done in this direction. Means both are perpendicular to each other. This is the diagram showing both of them perpendicular to each other. Here in this diagram you can see that both of them are in the same direction. Here you can see that the direction of the force and the direction of displacement are opposite to each other. Okay, so let's now discuss these conditions one by one. So let us find out the work done by the force in each of these cases. So the first case is force is acting in the direction of the displacement. That means the direction of the force and the direction of displacement are similar. Okay, displacement, I think you all have remembered what is displacement. Displacement is the minimum distance which is covered by the object, right? So the work done is denoted by the capital letter W. So work done by the force. Okay, so if this is the condition that the force and the displacement are in the same direction, then what work will be done? So work done by the force is equal to the product of the force and the displacement. Okay, so what will be the definition for work done now? Work done is equal to F multiplied by S. F is the force applied and S is the displacement done by the object. So in this case, you can see that the girl is pushing this table, right? You can see here in blur that the girl original position was here, right? So the girl started from here and the girl is applying the force in this direction. And you all have noticed that the table has also moved from here to here, right? So this is displacement. So direction of the force and the direction of the displacement are same in this case. So when we find work done by this force, it will be equal to force multiplied by displacement. And the unit of work is joule. This you will discuss later. Okay, now see this first picture. Here you can see that this boy is applying force onto this box, but the box here you can see S is equal to 0. It is written here S is equal to 0. S means displacement. So boy is applying the force, but there is no displacement in the box. That means when you find the work done by the boy, it comes to 0. Because force, you have kept the value F and displacement is 0. So you will put the value here 0. So 0 multiplied by any of the term comes to 0. So what has happened in picture number 1? In picture number 1, the boy is applying the force, but there is no displacement. So work done becomes 0. In the second picture, the girl is pushing the table in one particular direction and displacement is also seen in the same direction. So work done is equal to W, force multiplied by displacement. Fine. Now let us move on to the second case. Force is acting in a direction opposite to the displacement, right? Means force and displacement are in opposite direction. So what will be the work done now? See, if the force is acting opposite to the displacement of the body, which is in motion, the work done is negative, right? In the first case, you have seen that the work done in this case, in first one, it was positive. But now, when the force and displacement are in opposite direction, then the work done will be in negative value. For example, you can see the work done by frictional force. Okay, you can see here that force is applied in this direction. So movement of the box will also be in the same direction. Displacement will be in this direction. Okay, but the direction of the force and the direction of this motion, right? This is now, this pushing force we will not consider. Now you see that the box is moving in this direction, right? But the friction is acting in this direction. Okay, so displacement is in this direction towards right side, but this force, frictional force, is acting in opposite direction. That means the direction of the force and the direction of the displacement gets opposite to each other. And that's why the work done in this case by the frictional force is negative. The work done by the pushing force is positive. Right, because pushing force is applied in the right direction and displacement is also in the right direction. So here the work done by this force will be positive, but the work done by frictional force, because two forces are acting on the box, so the work done by the frictional force will be negative, because frictional force acts in the direction opposite to the displacement. Okay, so this is an example where the work done gets negative value by the frictional force. Another example, you can see that work done by gravity on an object thrown upwards is also negative. Now, gravity is also a force, gravitational force, right? We have studied just now in the lesson. So, suppose you have thrown any of the object in upward direction. So, this is the direction of displacement. The ball is moving in the upward direction. So, this is the displacement direction. But gravity is acting in opposite direction. Okay, so the direction of the force and the direction of displacement gets opposite to each other. So, what is the work done by gravity now? The work done by gravity will be a negative value. Okay, now in this picture also you can see that the train is moving in the forward direction. So this is the direction of the displacement, but this green color man is trying to just push the train from the opposite side. This is the external force applied from this direction. So this direction is of force and the displacement direction, you can see here that both are opposite to each other. So now the negative work has been done in this case. Okay, so work gets negative when the direction of the force and the direction of the displacement are opposite to each other. Now, the third case, force is acting perpendicular to the displacement. Now, when the force applied is perpendicular to the force, then there will be no displacement in the direction to the force. Work done in this case is zero. Fine. Now see this diagram. In this diagram, you can see here that force is applied towards the upside. This man is carrying a box. So the man is trying to push this box in the upward direction. So force is applied in the upward direction, but the man is moving in this direction. So displacement is in this direction. So force applied and this force which is applied on the box, okay, this force and the direction of the displacement are perpendicular to each other. Okay, so displacement is not in the direction of force. When displacement is not in the direction of force, then the work done becomes zero. Work done becomes zero. When they both are perpendicular to each other, when the displacement is not in the direction of the force and the force is perpendicular to the direction of displacement, in that case, the work done is zero. Remember this point. Okay, when force and displacement are perpendicular, the work done gets zero value. Okay. And the fourth case is that force is causing no displacement. Like this man is pushing the box, but there is no displacement in the box. So when displacement is zero, when S is zero, no work is done. So here also the value of work becomes zero. So in these two cases, when the force is perpendicular and when there is no displacement, in both of these cases, the work done is equal to zero. Okay, why here zero? I think it is clear because the displacement is there, but displacement is not in the direction of force and when they are perpendicular. Okay, so when they are perpendicular, the work done gets zero. Okay, now next one. What is the work done? Okay, so work done by a force which is acting on an object is equal to the product of the force and the displacement of the object in the direction of the force. Okay, the direction, the displacement must be in the direction of the force. Then only we can say that the work done is positive. If the displacement direction is not in the direction of force, then work done becomes zero. As you have seen that when the force and the displacement are perpendicular to each other, then work done becomes zero. So what is the correct definition for work done now? That work done by a force acting on an object, this is equal to the product of the force and the displacement in the direction of the force. Okay, displacement must be in the direction of the force, then only the work done is a positive value. Okay, now work is a scalar quantity. Okay, everything, every concept when we are starting, we are finding out whether it is a scalar or a vector quantity. So work is a scalar quantity because it has only magnitude, but it has no direction. There is no direction for work. In which direction the work is done, this is not there. So work is a scalar quantity as it does not has the direction. Now work done is the product of force and displacement, F into S. So unit of work is, see, unit of force is Newton and unit of displacement is meters. So the unit of work is Newton meter. And this Newton meter is given a special name which is called as joule. Okay, 1 joule means 1 Newton meter. So joule is the value or the unit of work done. So 1 joule work is said to be done. Now we are defining 1 joule. 1 joule work is said to be done when a force of 1 newton, right? Because what is the formula of work done? It is F multiplied by S, right? So what is 1 joule? 1 joule work is when a force of 1 newton displaces an object with 1 meter. okay, means 1 meter force you are applying, and if the object get displaced by 1 meter, that means the work done is 1 joule. Okay, from the formula you can just make your own definition. What is 1 joule? 1 joule is the work done when 1 newton force is applied on the object and it get displaced by 1 meter. Okay, then the work done is called 1 joule. So here you can see the definition. 1 joule is the amount of work done when a force of 1 newton acts on a distance of 1 meter in the direction of the force. Remember, the direction of the force and the direction of the displacement should be same, then only the work is positive. If both of them are opposite, then the work is negative. And if the force and displacement are perpendicular, the work done is zero. And if there is no displacement at all, then also the work done is zero. So this, you know, this phrase you have to add everywhere, in the direction of the force. Displacement must be in the direction of the force. Now, next one is energy. Okay, so this much we have studied about work done. Now we are starting another concept, that is energy. You can see in the picture here, the energy present inside the body of a human, okay, which helps and makes the person capable to do all sorts of work. So energy of an object is defined as the capacity for doing work. This is the definition for energy. Energy is the capacity for doing work. Okay, if you have energy, you can do the work. So energy is what? It is the capacity for doing work. And it is measured by the total quantity of work you can do. Right? So how much energy is there means how much quantity of work you can do. That defines that how much energy is present inside the person. So energy can also be said that it is the ability to do the work, or energy is the stored work. This can also be the definition, because energy is the capacity to do work. So we can say that energy is nothing but the stored work inside, which we are utilizing then to do the work. So it is the stored work, or ability to do the work, or capacity to do the work. So any one of the definition you can just write for energy. Now when an object does work, its energy decreases, right? When we are doing work, we are using our energy. So definitely the energy will go on decreasing. And at the last moment, we feel tired, right? So when the object does the work, its energy decreases. On the other hand, if work is done on the object, its energy increases. Okay, the one who is doing the work, its energy decreases. But the object on which the work is done, its energy increases. That simply means that there is a transfer of energy from one object to another object. Okay, you have studied in lower classes also that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. Energy can only be transferred. Fine. Like when we on the switch of a fan, what happens? Electrical energy gets converted to mechanical energy. Okay, so there is a transfer of energy. When you on the bulb, electrical energy gets converted to heat and light energy. So there is a transfer of energy. So the one who is doing the work, its energy will decrease, and the object on which the work is done, its energy will increase. So that means there is a transfer of energy whenever a work is done. Okay, so there is a transfer. Now, next one. How does an object possess energy? Possessing energy perform the work. Okay, that means suppose an object has energy, so how the object is able to perform the work. So suppose an object A possesses the energy, and so suppose A is a human, any object. Okay, suppose A is a human and that human possesses some energy in the body. So that object A can exert the force on object B. Right, so the one who is having the energy will definitely exert force on another body. And while the object A is exerting force on the object B, transfer of energy takes place. So energy will get transferred from body A to body B. Right, so suppose this is body A and this is body B. Now initially A was having energy, and when A is applying force on B, when A applies force on B, what is happening? Energy is getting transferred to B. And due to this energy transfer, the B can move from its position, or B can also do some sort of work, because now B gets energy. So B will be able to move now, or B will be able to do some work now. So A, does A made the B move? Okay, so A, what does A has done? A has made object B to move and perform some work. That means A has the capacity to do the work. Right? This happens, and in this way the work is done. So anything which has energy will apply force on the other thing, energy will be transferred, and then the other object will be either displaced or, you know, will be able to do some work, right? When we are kicking a ball, suppose, so we are transferring our energy to ball. So ball will also start moving. So this is the transfer of energy, and then we can say that the work is done. So now let's see what is the unit of energy. So energy is the capacity of doing work. Energy is nothing but the stored work or the capacity to do the work. So the unit of energy is also joule. As the unit of work is also joule, the unit of energy is also joule, and it is represented by the capital letter J. So 1 joule is the energy which is required to perform 1 joule of work. Okay, what is 1 joule of energy? 1 joule of energy is that much energy which is required to do the work of 1 joules. And there are bigger units of joule also. 1 kilojoule is equal to 1000 joules. And 1 megajoule is equal to 10^6 joules. These are the bigger units of joules, right? Kilojoules and megajoules. Megajoule means 10^6 joules. Okay. So this is about energy. Now here also one of the example you can see that there is a golfer, right? The player who plays the golf. So energy is there in the golfer. So now the device which they hold in their hand to kick the ball, to hit the ball, I must say. So that device is called the club. Right. So there was energy in the golfer. Now golfer does work on club. Okay, golfer was holding the club and he does work on it. So now what happens? The energy in the golfer gets transferred to the club. Right? Golfer has transferred his energy to the club. And club does work on the ball. Now the golfer is hitting the ball with the help of this club. So what will happen? Energy from the golfer first pass on to the club. And then from the club, the energy gets passed on to the ball. Right? And then the ball starts moving. So this is how the work is the transfer of the energy. This is how the work is done. Golfer has done the work on club. Club has done the work on ball. So work is nothing but the transfer of energy from one person to another. Fine? Okay, so we have come to the end of this video session. So let's see at last what we have done. So we have learned about work. What is work? Then work done by the constant force. Then units of work we have studied. And then energy and units of energy. Okay, so the work done is the product of force multiplied by displacement, and displacement must be in the direction of force. Then only it is positive. Otherwise, in opposite case, it is negative. If the force and the displacement are perpendicular, then the work done will be zero. And if there is no displacement at all, then also the work done will be zero. Unit is joule. Energy is the capacity to do the work, and its unit is also joule. So this is the starting. These are the starting concepts of the lesson. Now, next topics will continue in the next session. Till then, all of you will read from your textbook and stay home, stay safe, and keep learning.